chapter 7 chapter name was list manipulation okay up to last class we discussed about chapter 5 string manipulation so in this class we are going to discuss about the new chapter list manipulation okay let us see what are the concepts we are going to see in this chapter that is agenda of this video classes creating and accessing list okay first we are going to see a creating list and then we discuss about accessing list so under this concept so many sub topics are there so let us see one by one okay so first one is creating list so before I'm going to explain about creating a list first we must know what is meant by list what is meant by list here a list are containers used to store a sequence of values of any type a list are containers used to store a sequence of values of any type okay you know very well a list are mutable type what is meant by mutable type that is the elements in a list we can change the elements in the list in place that means in memory already I explained what is meant by mutable and what is meant by immutable with the help of diagram we discussed already okay so now we are going to see creating a list okay here how we can create the list here we are putting the so many expressions within a square bracket okay here list of values are represented within a square bracket okay here the brackets the square brackets indicates the starting and ending of the list here the square bracket indicates starting and ending of the list okay I will explain with the help of the Python language let us see see here student here l1 is a list name l1 is a list name that's your wish you can use any variable name here I can represents the a list of integers here if I want to represents the list of integers just I have mentioned here 1 2 3 are known as the list of integers here each list values are separated by comma each list values are separated by each values in the list are separated by commas okay the next l2 what I said that is we can store the list of values the sequence of values of any type that means here we can give the integer value or float value or mixed type of value also we can represent as a list okay see here 1, 2.5, 3.4 see here three values are used one is integer type then another both remaining both are floating type okay if we want to display the list value so it is display okay the next one is we can represent that single character also that is r a t here a list of single characters I have represented here did you understand the next one is a mixed type of value suppose l4 is equal to a one is integer type then another one is a floating type then one is a single character then another one is string type so here we can give a sequence of values of any type we can store a sequence of values of any type here the mixed type of values I have given so that here the list name is l4 okay see if you are printing, so it prints the list name, that list values. Okay, so one, first one is integer, then second one is floating point, then third one is single character, then fourth one is string. Okay, did you understand? Okay, the next one is, see here, in creating a list, it's having two form. It's having two form. So first one is empty, so it does not contain any value. The second one is, here we are representing the list of values of any type. Okay, so see here, for example, L is equal to empty. That means it's equivalent to zero. It's equivalent to zero. See, suppose if I am printing L value, it shows only empty list. Okay, did you understand? The next one is, okay, some other way also we can represent the list value. So the first one is empty list. So before that, see here, I have represented the form for general form for creating a list. Now see, these both are known as list display construct. These both are known as list display construct. Okay, let us see some more example. Our first one is empty list. First one is empty list. Already I explained that how to represent the empty list. So one more way we can represent the empty list, that is L is equal to list of. So this is also representing the empty, to represent the empty list. See here, it also display the empty list. Did you understand? The next one is a long list. Long list means, suppose a list contains many values. A list contains many values. It is also possible. We can give a long list. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 34, 35, 36, 67, 89, 8, 9, then 98, 34, 23, 56. So like that we can give. Like that we can give. This is example for long list. Okay. The next one is, nested list. What is meant by nested list? A list within a list is known as known as nested list. Okay, I will tell one example. L is equal to 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5. See here, how many elements I represented here? Only 4. Only 4. Because here a 3, 4, these value as counted as 1s. These values are counted as that is 1. See here. So 1, 2. Here 3, 4 are one type of list. So I nested this list into the list L. I nested the list, that is 3, 4, into the list L. Okay. Suppose if we want to know this length of the list, if we want to know this length of the list, so what will be the length of the list? You are having any idea? 4. How? See here, using the length function, you can know the length of the list, because here that list contains only the 4 elements, so it displays the length as 4. How? Because here the 3, 4, these lists are counted as 1s. These lists are counted as 1. Okay, so 1, 2, then 3, then 4. You can access the list elements with the help of their indexes. We will see later. Okay, here just we have discussed empty list, then long list, then nested list. Okay, a list comes within the list, that is within another list, are known as nested list. Okay. The next one is creating list from existing sequence. Creating list from existing sequence. Here we are using the built-in list type object to create the list from existing sequence. Okay, the syntax of this is L is equal to list of sequence. Here the sequence may be any kind of object. That means like it includes a list or tuples or string. Okay, here the sequence represents that any kind of object, it in that including a list, string and tuples. Okay, see the example I have given. L1 is equal to list of computer. Here which type of sequence I used, that is string type. Which type of sequence I used, a string type. So after that, if we want to know the output for this variable, that is L1, see this output COMPUTER. So what will happen here, I have taken the sequence type as string, but here it generates the individual elements. It generates the individual element from the individual letter of this string. Okay, it generates the individual element from the individual letters of the string. Did you understand? Okay, so it displays, it takes the individual character from the string and it is displayed. Did you understand? Let us see with the help of the example. For example, L is equal to the same thing I am going to use, then a list of computer. Here I used which type of sequence, that is string type. Here I used which type of sequence, string type. Okay, suppose if I want to get the output for this list, it displays like this, because it generates the individual element from a string. Okay, it generates the individual elements from a string, computer. Did you understand? The next one is similarity with string. Okay, so these concepts are under the topic accessing a list. So let us see one by one. Our first one is similarity with string. You know, up to last class we discussed about the chapter 5. Chapter is string manipulations. Okay, some concepts are similar. Some concepts are in the list are similar to string. Okay, did you understand? Some concepts are in the list are similar to string. Let us see. So what are the concepts are given in the list is similar to string. See, first one is length. Okay, so a length function, length is used to find out the length of the given list. Okay, length of the given list. Now only we have seen, that is nested list. So 1, 2, that is, see, I will explain. So the length of the list, so these concept is similar to a string. See, L is equal to just how many elements I have represented, that is 5. So list of integers I represented. So if we want to know this length of the list, so just you can simply give by using the length function. So now the length of the list is 5. Length of the list is 5. Did you understand? This concept is similar to string. This concept is similar to string. For your understanding purpose, I will explain a string concept also. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here I have represented a string, that is a string of string value. If we want to find out the length of the string, it also displays the 5. Okay, so length concept is similar to length concept in list is similar to string. Okay, the next one is indexing and slicing. Indexing and slicing. So the general form I represented here. First one is L of I. L of I. What is meant by that? Just it returns the item at the index I. It returns the item at the index I. Next one is L of I colon J. What is the meaning for this? Just it returns the item between the index I and J. Here I value is included but J value is excluded. Okay, I value is included, J value is excluded. So these indexing and slicing in concept in the list is similar to string. Okay, I will explain. See here. For example, string cat. Okay, first s of 0. So s of 0, it returns the character C. Suppose the same character I am going to represent in a list, that is C A then T. Okay, see here, the three characters I represented inside the list. You know your list values are represented within a square bracket. So these square bracket indicates that starting and ending of the list. Starting and ending of the list. Now if we want to access the list values with the help of this index, so how? See here, L of 0. So we are getting the character C. So indexing and slicing concept in the list are similar to string. Okay, the next one is concatenation and replication. Concatenation and replication. So these concepts are in the list are same to like to string. That is concatenation and replication concepts in the list are similar to string. Okay, see, S is equal to cat. Okay, the next 1, 2, 3. Then S1 is equal to 3, 4, 5. So how we can perform the concatenation operation? With the help of the operator plus. S plus S1. So just we are getting 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5. Okay, next in list how we can perform the concatenation operation. Okay, so the same operator we will use, that is plus operator is used to concatenating the two list. Example, L is equal to that is 1, 2, 3. Then L1 is equal to 3, 4, 5. So how we can concatenate these two lists with the help of the plus operator, L plus L1. So what type of output we are getting? Just the second list is added at the end of the first list. The second list values are added at the end of the first list. Did you understand? So what are the concepts in the list are similar to string and length, then indexing and slicing, then concatenation and replication. Okay, so one more concept also similar, that is membership operator. That is membership operator. So what are all the operators are coming under this membership operator? In and not in. So in and not in operator are used to check whether the element is present inside the list or not, whether the element is present in the list or not. Let us see. L1 is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 comma 5. So how many values I represented? 5 values, that is list of integers. Now I am going to check 5 in L1. Okay, now I am going to check the element 5 is present inside the list L1 or not. If it is present, it returns true. If it is not present, it returns false. Let us see. True, because the element 5 is present inside the list. Okay. Next term, 6 in L1. It returns false because the element 6 is not in the list. Okay. For example, 6 not in L1. See here, yes, the element 6 is not presented in the list L1. So, it returns true. Did you understand, student? So, len and indexing and slicing, then membership operator, then concatenation and replication operators. These concepts are in the list is similar to the string. Okay, these concepts are similar with the string. Did you understand? So replication I did not tell. Okay, let us see. L1 is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3. Okay, suppose if we want to repeat the list a particular number of times, we can use that multiplication operator. Okay, that is L1 star 3. So what is the meaning for this? The given list is replicated into 3 times, replicated as 3 times. Did you understand? The next one is accessing individual elements. Accessing individual elements. So these concepts also similar to string. Okay, accessing individual elements in a list are similar to the string concept. That is, how we can access these string elements? That is, we can access these string elements with the help of their indexes. So like that, we can access the individual elements of a list are accessed. That means we can access the individual elements of a list through their indexes. Through their indexes. Already you know, often I explained, that is the Python will support two-way indices, that is forward index and backward index. Let us see. For example, L is equal to 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Here, a list of integers I have represented. How we can access this elements present in the list? With the help of their indexes. With the help of their indexes. Let us see. L of 0. So, it displays the element 11. Suppose, L of minus 1. So, it displays the element 15. So, Python will support both type of indices, that is forward index, then backward index. Okay. The next one is difference from strings. So, the string, that is a list, some of the concepts we have seen in the list. So, some concepts are in the list are similar to string, similar to string, but only one concept is differ from string. Okay, only one concept in the list is differ from the string. How? That is mutability. Mutability, what I said, that is strings are immutable. Strings are immutable, but a list are mutable. You know what is meant by immutable? That is, we can change the elements, that is immutable. We cannot change the elements in place, in memory. But mutable, we can change the elements in place. Place means nothing but memory. Okay? Let us see. I will tell example. Here, first we will check the example string. What I said here, the string are immutable type. That means we cannot change the element which is present in the string. Okay, that means in place. We cannot change the element in place. Let us see. S is equal to Python. Okay, just I have assigned the string to the variable, to the string variable yes. Okay, I assign the string Python to the string variable yes. Okay, s of 0 is equal to I'm going to assign the string value, that is character h, in place of 0. That is in place of 0, that is what character is I assigned, that is the character p. But if we want to change the character p as h, so what will happen? The Python will shows error because strings are immutable. So here the string object does not support item assignment, does not support item assignment. So next up, suppose in list we will check. Here lists are mutable. We can change the element in a list in place. Okay, see, L is equal to T Y T H O N. Okay, so here I have represented a single character, list of single characters. Okay, suppose if I want to change the character which is at the index 0 as h, is it possible? Yes, it is possible. See, let us check what happened. Here the character p is changed as h. So what I said, lists are mutable but string are immutable. Did you understand? So if we want to change the elements in a list are possible. Did you understand? The next one is, traversing a list. What does mean by traversing a list? The same concept, that means we have discussed in string also. That means traversing a string. What does mean by traversal? That means here we are accessing and processing each element in a sequence manner. As that means a traversal of a sequence means accessing and processing each element. Accessing and processing of each element. Okay, that is a traversing a list. How we can perform in the traversing a list? With the help of for loop. With the help of for loop. See the syntax. For item in list, process each item here. So through this for loop, we can access and processing each element of the list. We can access and processing each element of the list. Let us see. I will explain with the help of the Python program. Here L is equal to just a list of single characters I am going to mention. God. Okay, so it contains the list variable contains a list of a single characters. Okay, so we can perform the traversing operations. Okay, the for a in l. Okay, here we are checking if the characters, that is here the variable, that is the looping variable a, will take each and every character in a list one at a time, each and every character from a list one at a time. Okay, now a print of a. Okay, see, we will run this program. Just we have to save d.py. See here, what type of output we have got? G, O, D. Okay, so these characters are displayed in a vertical manner. So the looping variable A will take each and every character from the list one at a time. Did you understand? Traversing a list means we can access and processing the elements of a list. The next one is comparing list. How we can compare the two lists? With the help of the standard comparison operators. You know what are all the standard comparison operators are available in Python? Less than, greater than, is equal to, then not equal to, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. Okay, let us see one by one. That is, I have given some example. L1 is equal to 1 comma 2. A list L1 contains a 2 integer value. Then list 2 L2 is contains 2 integer value. Here we are checking both L1 and L2 are equal. Suppose if it is equal, it returns true. Here a 2 list elements, two list elements must be of comparable types. Okay, must be of same type. We will check. See here, with the help of the Python program, I will explain. L1 is equal to 2 comma 3 comma 4. Okay, then L2 is equal to 3 2 comma 3 comma 4. Now we are checking L1 is equal to L2. If the condition is true, so both lists are equal, it returns true. Both lists are equal, it returns true. Here the elements in both lists, it checks the each element, each corresponding elements in these two lists. First it will take first value in the list L1 and second first value in the list L2. If it is equal, okay, then it moves to the next. So L1, the second value in the list L1, then second value in the list L2. If it is equal, okay, then control will move to next one. Here the first value, that is the third value in the list L1, is compared with the third value in the list L2. If it is equal, okay. So here also I have mentioned, that is 2, 3, 4, and then in list 2 also I used 2, 3, 4. So same type of values if it is given, so it gives the result true. Okay. Let us check. L1 is equal to 3, 4, 5. Then L2 is equal to 4, 5, 6. Now L1 is equal to L2. So what will happen? False. Because it checks the each and every element that is present in these two lists. The corresponding element are checked here. First, it checks, first it will take the value, first value of the L1 is compared with the first value of the L2. But it, what happened? It's not equal. So then second value also not equal. Then third value also not equal. So it gives the result false. Okay. The next one is non comparison operators. Non comparison operators means a less than greater than. We will check L is equal to 1, 2, 7, 8. Okay, then L1 is equal to 1, 2, 8, 9. Okay, see here we are going to use non-comparison operator. We are going to use non-comparison operator. That means L less than L1. So what will happen? It returns true. How it returns true? First, what I said, first it takes the first element in the list L is compared with the first element in the list L1. So if both are equal, so what will happen? Just it moves to the next element. Did you understand? If both first elements which are in the list L and L1 are equal, just it moves to the next element. Again it checks. So the second element in the list L is compared with the second element of the list L1. So here also equal. So the control will, that means it moves to the next element for checking. So here what will happen? So the 7, 8, the third element in the list L is compared with the third element of the list L1. See here, 7 less than 8. Here the condition is true. So then only we are getting the result true. We are getting the result true. Until it checks the condition, until that is the number will be differ. The number will be differ. Did you understand? The next one is, comparison operators. Refer your book also. Having any doubt, we will clear the next class. The next one is eval function. Next one is eval function. So I did not mention this in the Ajanta concept. Just I'm going to explain what is meant by eval function. So if we want to give the, that means if we want to give the integer value, that means I will explain with the help of the Python program. See, ideally mode we can take. See here, A is equal to input of enter the value. A is equal to input of enter the value. So what type of value we can give to this variable A? That is a string value only we can give. Okay, so if we are giving an integer value to this string, to this variable A, but it will return the type as string. It will return the type as string. Let us check. Print of type of A. Okay, let us run. See here, enter the value. Suppose here I am entering the value 1, 2, 3. Just integer value only I have entered. So what will happen? But it returns the what type? String type. Even if I am giving the integer type value, but the Python will return this type as string. Okay. So how we can convert this? We can convert this with the help of this int of function or float of function. Suppose if we want to convert the given string as integer type, means we have to use that is int of function. If we want to convert the given string as float type, means we have to use that is float type function. So apart from this, if we want to convert the string, suppose whatever type we are giving, we have to get the correct type related to that value. How? With the help of the evolve function. With the help of the evolve function. Let us see. See here. Evolve. Just I used only evolve function. Now we will check. So A is equal to evolve input, enter the value, a print type of A. So what will happen? So what type of input we are giving? So based on that, the type is displayed. Suppose see here, I have given integer type value to the variable A. Now what type of output we are getting? See, the type is integer. Okay. Suppose if I am going to give a float type value, if I am going to give a float type value, that is 3.0 to the variable A. So what will happen? It displays the exact type of this value, that is float. So the evaluate function is used to even if we are giving the string value or what type of value if we are giving, so for that the given value is converted. That means if we are giving a string type value, string value, that is it displays the type as string, it returns a string type. If we are giving an integer value, it returns the int, it returns the type as int. If we are giving a float value, it returns the type as float. Okay, so then one more use is that in evolve function, that means the evolve function is used to evaluate the mathematical expression. Evolve function is used to evaluate the mathematical expression, and it evaluates the string expression and returns the integer as a result. For example, see here, I will explain. A is equal to C 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Okay, see here, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, these I enclosed with the help of the double quotes. Okay, suppose if I'm printing the value of A, if I'm printing the value of A, so what will happen? So it displays the value as it is. So whatever I have mentioned inside the double quotes, the same thing is displayed on the screen. Let us see what type of output we are getting. See, the 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. Okay, suppose if we are using evolve function, so what will happen? Just it evaluates the expression and returns the result into the integer form. Returns the result in the integer form. So let us see here, I'm going to use evolve function. So what will happen? Just it evaluates the given expression, given a string expression, that is run the module. What will happen? Just it adds the all the numbers, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, every numbers are added. So the result is 15. That means it evaluates the string expression and it gives the result. That means it returns the result into integer format. Did you understand? The syntax I have forgotten to tell. See here, the syntax for this evaluate function, evolve function is evolve expression, then global, then local. Here global and local both are optional. We are using this global to represent a dictionary, then here the local as a mapped object. Did you understand? Then here the expression is a string expression. Okay. So what are all the concepts we have seen in this class? That means creating and accessing list. So under this concept, we discussed many subtopics. I hope you understood my class. We will see in next class. Thank you, student.